Hello everyone. So, I've been spending quite a bit of time with the Galaxy S4, as you know, and I made a video the other day where I rounded up some of the problems I've been having. So I've done lots more investigation work. I've rooted, I've ROMed, I've installed updates from Samsung from around the globe, ran updates for a couple of days, tried to work out, you know, are things improving for the S4 over time? Now, the version of the S4 software that I had come out on my device on day one, unfortunately was completely unfinished. You can tell that straight away by comparing the videos. For starters, the later updates that landed, you know, a couple of weeks after the S4 was released, or, you know, over this preceding period of time, have made quite a lot of major changes. For starters, the overall startup and home screen experience has changed quite a bit. There are now a lot more sort of mini tutorials, including an alert that comes down from the top to tell you about WatchOn, for instance, the infrared app. Generally, the device has got better, but strangely, I now have interface lag, which I didn't have on my stock day one ROM, as it were, and you can feel that occasionally. It's not massively problematic, it just seems to be when it's moving between applications and occasionally coming into the app tray, and it will just sort of go stutter, stutter, stutter. You sort of think, well, what was causing that? You're not downloading anything, nothing's installing. Why stutter? Very strange. The heat issue, I've managed to sort of narrow it down. There is still an issue, but it happens under a very specific set of conditions. In essence, if you have the screen brightness turned up, and I mean not using the auto brightness, but having your screen brightness turned up, as most of us do, we tend to crank the screen brightness when we first get devices to go, wow, look how bright and shiny that is, brilliant. If you're then playing a game, and at the same time you happen to be running the Wi-Fi because you're downloading something, or a game is a multiplayer game and so it's hammering away on the Wi-Fi, then the amount of heat that is generated around this top section of the screen is pretty phenomenal. And the reasoning for that is that you're going to have the light system that actually powers the screen that creates the brightness, the LED, I believe it's LED in here anyway, is going to be somewhere up on the top corner and probably another one somewhere down here or towards the side. You've got your Wi-Fi and baseband chip, which powers your Wi-Fi, your 3G and everything, that's up in your top corner. And best I can tell, because if I have those items turned off and still play a game, the 3G chip is also somewhere up on the top corner here as well. And you add all of those things together, using all of those elements at once, and wow, does she get hot. Like I say, in my experience, too hot to actually use comfortably for longer than 20 minutes. Anecdotal if you like, but what I found is, if you happen to disable the baseband, so get rid of your Wi-Fi, get rid of your 3G, temporarily, then play a game with the screen brightness at either auto or turned down quite a fair way, then actually it's fine to use, it's quite comfortable. But like I say, when you get all of these things going on at once, things become quite a bit more difficult. Is this something Samsung are going to be able to fix? Well, maybe they can make a few changes in their firmwares as they come out. But I would have thought, just because of where these items are located, and obviously the use case, running the Wi-Fi, running the screen, running a game, that area just heats up, and it will just keep heating up. Now, I don't think it's going to be something that's a technical fault. I don't think your S4 is going to explode or anything like that, but it's an area where, under these particular circumstances, there is an extra amount of heat generated that, for my mind, just makes it uncomfortable. Overall, though, these updates that I've been running have improved the Galaxy S4 quite significantly. One of the major changes that they made is allowing you to actually uninstall some of the bloat apps that they put on. For instance, Daily Motion and Deezer. You can now go in and you can uninstall those if you want to. Previously, you couldn't. They were basically locked at the root level and you'd have to use an unbloater to get rid of them. So that was quite interesting. It certainly, as I said originally, felt like Samsung had rushed out the software. And to a certain extent, maybe rush the manufacturing as well, with the manufacturing defect that I had on mine. But it's good to see that they are pushing these updates out quickly. The updates, though, however, are still network dependent in a lot of cases. And so for me, I wasn't able to get an official update, as it were. I had to go onto XDA developers, grab an update from there, flash that using Odin, absolutely bonza. But Samsung are playing a little bit of a game. They've started doing funny things that make it harder for us to install our recovery tools or root the Galaxy S4. Just generally making life more difficult than it absolutely has to be for developers and for third parties. Part of that is going to be down to the new Google Galaxy, the Google S4, should I say, this developer edition device that Google are going to be releasing in June, which is essentially a Galaxy S4, but without Samsung's modifications. It's pure Android running on it. And we will be taking a look at that to see you know, how that operating system measures up. And more importantly, how much lighter weight it is. And does it solve any of the flaws that I've kind of highlighted here, which may be more TouchWiz Samsung related than pure Android. It'll be very interesting to see how the hardware stacks up, the same hardware stacks up on two different operating systems, as it were. One, the pure Android Google Vision, and one where Samsung has taken the extended Android in a number of different ways. But overall, I'm starting to become a little bit more happier with my Galaxy S4. Now I've sort of seen some of the more strange things the Galaxy S4 likes to do and the combinations it likes to work in and doesn't in some cases, I'm becoming a little bit happier. It is a very, very powerful device. The software layer is very well done on the Galaxy S4. And, you know, the TouchWiz, we can argue all day long which is better, TouchWiz, HTC Sense, Android Pure, or launchers off the Google Play Store. But overall, the Galaxy S4 is a nice device. I'm getting more and more used to it. And like I say, the heat issue is annoying, but it's not that annoying once you realise that it's only under a specific set of circumstances and you can work around it. Would I like Samsung to make some changes and improve that scenario a little bit? Of course I would. It would be great if they could make the Wi-Fi not run quite as hot, because I think that's the tipping point at the moment. But other than that, I'm starting to like the Galaxy S4 for all of its little quirks and strangeness, and it's nice to see that Samsung are making some changes. Oh, and incidentally, this is possibly a little bit of exclusive. I had a response from Samsung's UK representatives the other day, querying about the headphone jack. Now, they weren't able to say, yes, we've got a fix in the way. They weren't able to tell me that, you know, everything will be solved or anything like that. But what they did tell me is they're aware of the problem. And more importantly, they're looking into it. So that's not a fix. That's not a whoops, we messed up, we're going to, you know, replace handsets or anything like that. But Samsung are acknowledging they know about the problem and they are looking into how it can be resolved, if it can be resolved, I suppose. I won't put words in their mouth. They quite literally just said they're looking into it and they're aware of the issue. That's absolutely fantastic, and at least that's a response. So for all of you guys who have got the headphone jack problem on the Galaxy S4, bear in mind, Samsung are aware of the problem and they are looking into it. Let's hope we see some movement on that shortly to alleviate the problem for all of us suffering the headphone jack issue. So that's where I am with the Galaxy S4 currently. We've had some bad days and we're moving into some good days, which is always nice to say.